Hello, it's Andy Graham of HoboTraveler.com. I've traveled nonstop for 16 plus years and went to 101 countries. I'm in Malta, and I wanted to celebrate the Hostel Malti. Pretty good hostel. I think it's the closest to the Pascheville, probably the big party place here. But this is an actual bunk bed that Chris designed, I guess, and had made. And what's great about it is, of course, what I'm looking for when I rent a room is I look through all the pictures for the hostel or the hotel or whatever, or hostel, I guess, and I'm trying to look for a locker. So if I could have seen this locker, I don't know if I did or not, but this is big enough to actually put a bunk, put your whole backpack inside, and then it's got good gliders on the bottom, sliders or gliders, you know, the things. I can put my own combination lock on it. And I'm going to include a video after this showing a locker in Kosovo that basically where they gave you the lock and basically the key worked for every single locker in the dorm. But this will hold my whole thing. So I've got as much security as I want. Yeah, so he's got the rail, of course, across the top to keep people from falling out when they're drunk. And they've got the little shelf, and then each person's got their own power point or electrical outlet. And so this is a really good bunk bed. I can actually sit down on the bunk bed on the lower bunk without hitting my head, which is really nice for a tall guy. And it's solid enough that it doesn't creak, it doesn't wiggle and whatever. It doesn't make noise when people are trying to climb in the upper bunk. So this is a pretty much an ideal thing. I would prefer with the curtain across the thing and my own light on the inside so I could read my book all night long. I actually do like the curtain across. That. This is a pretty hot country, and the room doesn't have air conditioning, so that could be really very hot for you. But you can see that this is a pretty much an ideal situation. Okay, Andy Graham, Hobo Traveler, trying to explain bunk beds in or dorm beds in hostels in Europe or anywhere in the world. You really always want to use your own combination, your own lock, and you don't want to buy it locally. You really try to have it, bring it from home. I got one that I, because a lot of times in cheap countries, the key will work in almost every single lock. They'll have only 10 keys for all the locks on the whole country. So bring a lock from home, a master, a good lock, and lock your stuff up, and then you don't have to use it, but anybody that gives you a locker that won't fit your computer or your camera in it isn't really, they're just trying to get that listing on their booking that says they have secure lockers, but they're really not. Or the ones that say that you must trust the hostel and give your valuables to them. Really, the control of your valuables should always be in the hands of the person that's, you know, traveling, not the thing. You want the person I'm worried about is the hotel owners. I'm not worried about Chris, but generally, you're going to get robbed by one of the workers or the hotel owners pretty much more often, actually, than you would from one of the other travelers. Okay, Andy Graham, HoboTraveler.com. In Malta. I'm in the Hostel Malti, and this is the bed designed by Chris, the owner. Hello, it's Andy Graham of HoboTraveler.com. I'm going to show you why I like my own padlock on things. I'm in a hostel in Europe, and this is my locker, number one, so I can open it. This is closed. This is locker number two. This is my key. So I'll show you. It's locked, right? Basically, the key works on all the lockers. So, you know, you can understand why I like to put my own padlock on. It's really just a Charlie Foxtrot. Okay, Andy Graham, Hobo Traveler, a budget traveler. I've been traveling nonstop for 16 plus years and went to 95 countries. I'm in Kosovo right now, but the hostel over here is really nice. I'm not saying this is bad, it's just that this type of locking system is just not correct.